failure. The word alone can send shivers down your spine. It conjures images of disappointment, shame, and lost opportunities. But what if I told you that this very thing you fear is the secret ingredient to your success? Picture the Wright brothers tinkering with their flying machine. Imagine Thomas Edison surrounded by thousands of failed light bulb prototypes. Think of Steve Jobs fired from the company he founded. These names ring out in history, not because they never failed, but because they failed spectacularly and kept going. A journey that will challenge everything you've been taught about success and failure. We're going to dive deep into the counterintuitive truth that to truly succeed, you must be willing to fail. And not just willing, you must embrace failure, seek it out, and learn to dance with it. Now, I know what some of you are thinking. Embrace failure. That's crazy talk. But stick with me, because by the end of our time together, you'll not only understand why failure is crucial to success, you'll be itching to go out there and fail your way to the top. Let's start with a simple question. What's holding you back right now? Is it fear of failure? Fear of looking foolish? Fear of losing what you already have? These fears are natural, but they're also the invisible chains that keep us tethered to mediocrity. It's time to break free. A child learning to walk, they fall down countless times. But do we call them failures? Do we tell them to give up and just crawl for the rest of their lives? Of course not. We encourage them. We celebrate their efforts. And we know that each fall brings them one step closer to running, jumping, and dancing. So why do we treat ourselves so differently as adults? When did we decide that failure was something to be avoided at all costs, rather than a natural and necessary part of growth? The truth is, success and failure are not opposites. They're partners in the dance of achievement. Every great success story is built on a foundation of failures. The key is learning to see those failures not as endpoints, but as stepping stones. Let me share a personal story. Early in my career, I was fired from a job I thought was my dream position. I was devastated. I felt like a failure in every sense of the word. But looking back, that failure was the best thing that ever happened to me. It forced me to reassess my goals, to dig deep and discover what I truly wanted to achieve in life. That moment of failure became the catalyst for the success I enjoy today. This pattern repeats throughout history. Did you know that Walt Disney was once fired from a newspaper for lacking imagination and having no original ideas? Imagine if he had let that failure define him. We live in a world without Mickey Mouse, without Disneyland, without the countless magical stories that have shaped generations. Or consider J.K. Rowling. Before Harry Potter became a global phenomenon, her manuscript was rejected by 12 different publishers. Each rejection was a failure, but each failure was also a step towards eventual success. The key is in how we frame these experiences. When we fail, and we will fail, make no mistake about it. We have two choices. We can let that failure defeat us, or we can let it teach us. We can see it as the end of the road or as a detour that leads to even greater destinations. Now, I'm not saying failure feels good. It doesn't. Failure can be painful, embarrassing, and discouraging. But it's also inevitable if you're pushing yourself to grow, to innovate, to achieve great things. The only way to avoid failure entirely is to never try anything new, to never take risks, to never stretch beyond your comfort zone. And let me tell you, that's the surest path to a life of regret. So how do we reframe our relationship with failure? How do we learn to see it not as something to be feared, but as a valuable tool in our journey towards success? First, we need to understand that failure is not a reflection of our worth as human beings. Failing at something doesn't make you a failure. It makes you someone who had the courage to try. Every time you fail, you're joining the ranks of history's greatest achievers. You're in good company. Second, we need to shift our focus from the outcome to the process. Instead of fixating on whether we succeed or fail, we should ask ourselves, what can I learn from this experience? How can I use this to improve? What new opportunities does this open up? Every failure is a data point. It's valuable information about what doesn't work, which brings you one step closer to finding out what does work. Thomas Edison famously said of his many failed attempts to create the light bulb, "I have not failed. I've just found 10,000 ways that won't work." That's the mindset of a true innovator. Fear of failure is one of the most common and most paralyzing fears we face. It keeps us playing small, staying in our comfort zones, and settling for less than we're capable of achieving. But here's the thing about fear. It's often based on illusions. We fear failure because we imagine the worst possible outcomes. We picture humiliation, loss, and devastation. But in reality, the consequences of failure are rarely as dire as we imagine. And even when they are challenging, they're almost always temporary and surmountable. Ask yourself, what's the worst that could happen if I fail? Really imagine it in detail. Now ask yourself, could I survive that? Could I learn from it? Could I use it as a springboard to even greater success? In most cases, you'll find that the answer is yes. Moreover, consider the cost of not trying. What opportunities might you miss? What potential might go unfulfilled? What dreams might wither on the vine? When we let fear of failure hold us back, we're choosing the certainty of regret over the possibility of greatness. So how do we cultivate the courage to fail? It starts with small steps. Set yourself challenges that push you just outside your comfort zone. Maybe it's speaking up in a meeting when you'd usually stay silent. Maybe it's applying for a job you're not quite qualified for. Maybe it's finally starting that side business you've been dreaming about. Each time you take one of these risks, celebrate it, regardless of the outcome. Remember, the win is in the attempt, not just the result. By consistently pushing yourself to take these small risks, you're building your failure resilience muscle. You're teaching yourself that you can survive failure, learn from it, and come back stronger. Another powerful tool is reframing. Instead of seeing failures as endpoints, see them as experiments. Scientists don't view failed experiments as personal shortcomings. They view them as valuable data that informs their next attempt. Adopt this mindset in your own life. Every failure is an experiment that brings you closer to success. It's also crucial to surround yourself with the right people. Seek out mentors and peers who understand the value of failure, who will support you through your setbacks and celebrate your courage. Avoid those who criticize from the sidelines but never dare to enter the arena themselves. Remember, the most successful people in any field are often those who have failed the most. They're the ones who are willing to take risks, to put themselves out there, to fall down and get back up again and again. They're not superhuman. They've just learned to dance with failure instead of running from it. Failure is only truly failure. If you let it be the end of your story, the ability to persist in the face of setbacks is what separates those who achieve their dreams from those who don't. It's not about never falling. It's about always getting back up. Consider the story of Colonel Sanders, the founder of Kentucky Fried Chicken. He didn't start his franchise until he was 62 years old, and his famous chicken recipe was rejected 1009 times before a restaurant accepted it. Imagine if he had given up after the 100th rejection, or the 500th, or even the 1000th. The world would have missed out on his unique contribution. Or think about Arianna Huffington, whose second book was rejected by 36 publishers. She could have given up on her dreams of being a writer. Instead, she persisted and went on to build one of the most influential news websites in the world. The key to persistence is to detach your sense of self-worth from individual outcomes. Your value as a person is not determined by whether you succeed or fail at any given task. What matters is your willingness to keep trying, to keep learning, to keep growing. It's also important to celebrate your failures. Yes, you heard that right. Celebrate them. Each failure is evidence that you're pushing yourself, that you're daring greatly. Make it a habit to ask yourself after each setback, what did I learn? How did I grow? What will I do differently next time? By reframing failure in this way, you turn it from something to be feared into something to be valued. You create a mindset of continuous improvement where each setback is just another step on the path to success. Embracing failure doesn't mean being reckless or not caring about outcomes. It doesn't mean setting yourself up to fail on purpose. What it means is approaching challenges with a growth mindset, understanding that temporary setbacks are part of the journey, not the destination. It means doing your best, preparing thoroughly, and then being willing to take that leap into the unknown. It means understanding that perfection is the enemy of progress, and that done is often better than perfect. The tech industry, where the mantra is fail fast, fail often. This doesn't mean they want to produce bad products. It means they understand that the quickest way to success is to get something out there, learn from real-world feedback, and continuously iterate and improve. You can apply this principle to your own life. Instead of waiting for perfect conditions or trying to plan for every possible outcome, take action, put yourself out there, be willing to make mistakes, and learn from them. Each failure brings you closer to your ultimate success. Remember, success is not a straight line. It's a series of ups and downs, twists and turns. The path to achieving your dreams will be filled with obstacles, setbacks, and yes, failures. But each of these challenges is an opportunity to learn, to grow, to become stronger and more resilient. Imagine if every great inventor, entrepreneur, or artist had given up after their first failure. We'd live in a very different world. Innovation requires risk-taking, and risk-taking inevitably leads to some failures along the way. But those failures are the stepping stones to breakthroughs. Go out there and fail. Fail spectacularly. Fail in ways that teach you something new about yourself and the world. Fail in pursuit of your biggest dreams and loftiest goals. But don't just fail. Learn from your failures, analyze them, understand why things didn't work out as planned. Use that knowledge to refine your approach to come back stronger and more prepared. And most importantly, keep going. Remember that failure is not the opposite of success. It's a part of success. Every setback, every disappointment, every moment of doubt is shaping you into the person you need to be to achieve your goals. A time when you failed at something important to you, how did it feel in the moment? Probably pretty awful, right? But now, looking back, can you see how that experience shaped you? Can you recognize the lessons you learned, the strength you gained? Now imagine your future self looking back on the challenges you're facing today. What would that wiser, more experienced version of you say? Probably something like, keep going. This is hard, but it's worth it. You're learning, you're growing, you're getting closer to where you want to be. Let's dig deeper into this idea of failure as a teacher. Every failure carries within it a lesson, if we're willing to look for it. Sometimes these lessons are obvious, like realizing you need to better prepare for a presentation after fumbling your way through one. Other times, the lessons are more subtle, requiring reflection and introspection to uncover. One powerful practice is to keep a failure journal. After each setback or disappointment, take some time to write about the experience. What happened? What were you hoping for? What went wrong? And most importantly, what can you learn from this? This practice serves several purposes. First, it helps you process your emotions around the failure. It's okay to feel disappointed or frustrated. Acknowledging these feelings is part of the process. Second, it forces you to analyze the situation objectively, which can help you identify areas for improvement. And third, over time, you'll create a record of your growth and resilience, which can be incredibly motivating when you're facing new challenges. Another crucial aspect of turning failure into success is developing a growth mindset. This term, coined by psychologist Carol Dweck, refers to the belief that our abilities and intelligence can be developed through effort, learning, and persistence. People with a fixed mindset believe that their qualities are carved in stone. You're either smart or you're not, you're talented or you're not. This mindset makes failure feel catastrophic because it seems to confirm our worst fears about ourselves. But those with a growth mindset see failure differently. They view it as an opportunity to learn and improve. They understand that our brains are like muscles. The more we challenge them, the stronger they become. With this mindset, failure isn't a reflection of who you are, but a natural part of the learning process. Developing a growth mindset takes time and practice. It involves challenging your self-talk, reframing your experiences, and consistently pushing yourself out of your comfort zone. But the rewards are immense. With a growth mindset, you become more resilient, more adaptable, and more likely to achieve your goals. Some of the world's greatest inventions and discoveries came about as a result of failure. Alexander Fleming discovered penicillin when he accidentally contaminated a culture plate. Post-it notes were the result of a failed attempt to create a super strong adhesive. The microwave oven was invented after a researcher noticed that a chocolate bar in his pocket melted when he stood in front of a magnetron. These stories illustrate an important point. Sometimes failure can lead us to even greater opportunities than we initially imagined. But to seize these opportunities, we need to be open to them. We need to be willing to look at our failures from different angles, to question our assumptions, and to consider possibilities we hadn't thought of before. This is where creativity comes into play. Creative thinking isn't just for artists. It's a crucial skill for anyone who wants to turn failure into success. When you encounter a setback, try to approach it with curiosity rather than frustration. What if this failure is actually pointing me towards a better solution? What unexpected opportunities might this open up? Remember, every failure narrows down the field of what doesn't work, bringing you closer to what does. Edison didn't just invent the light bulb. He discovered 10,000 ways that didn't work. And each of those failures provided valuable information that ultimately led to success. Let's also consider the role of failure in personal growth. Often our greatest periods of growth come after our biggest failures. Why? Because failure has a way of shaking us out of our comfort zones, forcing us to reevaluate our assumptions and strategies. A time when you failed at something important to you, maybe you didn't get the job you wanted, or your business idea didn't pan out, or a relationship ended, in the moment it probably felt terrible. But looking back, can you see how that experience helped you grow? Maybe it forced you to develop new skills or to reevaluate your priorities. Maybe it led you to discover strengths you didn't know you had or to find opportunities you wouldn't have considered otherwise. Maybe it simply made you more resilient, better able to handle future setbacks. While it can be painful in the moment, it often leads to tremendous personal growth. But this growth doesn't happen automatically. It requires us to approach our failures with the right mindset, to be willing to learn, to adapt, and to keep moving forward. You fear failure. This fear is so common that psychologists have a name for us, atypophobia. And it can be incredibly limiting, holding us back from taking risks, trying new things, and reaching our full potential. But here's the thing. The fear of failure is often worse than failure itself. Our minds have a tendency to catastrophize, to imagine the worst possible outcomes. We picture ourselves humiliated, rejected, losing everything. But in reality, the consequences of failure are rarely as dire as we imagine. Moreover, when we let fear of failure hold us back, we're essentially choosing to fail by default. We're letting our fears make our decisions for us, rather than actively pursuing our goals and dreams. So how do we overcome this fear? One powerful strategy is to reframe failure as feedback. Instead of seeing failure as a final judgment on your abilities or worth, see it as information. It's data that you can use to adjust your approach, to refine your strategies, to get closer to your goals. Another strategy is to practice failing in low-stakes situations. Set yourself small challenges where the consequences of failure are minimal. This could be as simple as trying a new recipe, learning a new skill, or striking up a conversation with a stranger. The goal isn't to fail, but to get comfortable with the possibility of failure. By doing this, you're training your brain to see failure as a normal part of life rather than a catastrophic event. You're building your resilience muscle, preparing yourself for the bigger challenges ahead. Remember, courage isn't the absence of fear. It's the ability to act despite fear. And like any skill, courage can be developed through practice. Each time you face a fear, no matter how small, you're becoming braver. The importance of self-compassion in the face of failure. Often, we're our own harshest critics. When we fail, we berate ourselves, telling ourselves we're not good enough, smart enough, or talented enough. But this negative self-talk is not only unhelpful, it's actively harmful. Research has shown that self-compassion, treating ourselves with the same kindness we'd offer a good friend, is far more effective in helping us bounce back from failure. It allows us to acknowledge our pain without getting stuck in it, to learn from our mistakes without defining ourselves by them. Practicing self-compassion doesn't mean making excuses or avoiding responsibility. It means recognizing that failure is a universal human experience, that everyone struggles and makes mistakes. It means treating ourselves with understanding and kindness, especially when we're struggling. The next time you face a setback, try this. Imagine how you'd talk to a close friend in the same situation. Would you berate them, tell them they're worthless? Or would you offer words of encouragement, remind them of their strengths, help them see the lessons in the experience? Try offering yourself that same compassion. Let's also consider the role of preparation in turning failure into success. While we can't avoid failure entirely, we can certainly learn to fail better. This means approaching challenges with thoughtfulness and strategy rather than rushing in blindly. Before taking on a big challenge, ask yourself, what could go wrong? What obstacles might I face? How can I prepare for these potential pitfalls? This isn't about pessimism or expecting failure. It's about being realistic and proactive. By anticipating potential failures, you can create contingency plans. You can ensure you have the resources and support you need. You can identify areas where you might need to build your skills or knowledge. This kind of preparation doesn't guarantee success, but it does make you more resilient in the face of setbacks. It helps you fail forward to make your failures productive steps on the path to success rather than devastating blows. The importance of perspective when it comes to failure. Often when we're in the midst of a failure, it feels all-encompassing. we lose sight of the bigger picture. But zoom out and you'll see that failure is just one moment in a much larger story. Think about some of the most successful people you know or admire. I guarantee you their paths weren't smooth or straight. They're littered with failures, setbacks, and disappointments. But these people succeeded, not in spite of their failures, but because of how they responded to them. Every failure is an opportunity to reassess, to course correct, to come back stronger. It's a chance to show yourself and the world what you're made of. It's not the failure that defines you, but how you rise from it. Consider the story of Oprah Winfrey. Early in her career, she was fired from her job as a television reporter because she was deemed unfit for TV. Imagine if she had let that failure define her. Instead, she used it as motivation, as a challenge to prove her doubters wrong. And she went on to become one of the most influential media figures in history. Or think about Steve Jobs. When he was ousted from Apple, the company he co-founded, it seemed like a catastrophic failure. But Jobs later said that getting fired from Apple was the best thing that could have happened to him. It freed him to enter one of the most creative periods of his life, ultimately leading to his triumphant return to Apple and the creation of products that revolutionized multiple industries. These stories remind us that failure is not the end of the story, unless we choose to make it so. It's simply a plot twist setting the stage for an even greater comeback. Success is wonderful, but it's often in our moments of failure that we truly discover who we are. Failure tests our resolve, our values, our commitment to our goals. It reveals our true character. When you face a significant setback, ask yourself, who do I want to be in this moment? How can I respond in a way that aligns with my values and long-term goals? These moments of adversity are opportunities to strengthen your character, to become the person you aspire to be. Remember, success is not just about achieving external goals. It's about becoming the best version of yourself. And often, it's our failures and how we respond to them that shape us into that best version. Often, our fear of failure stems from a narrow definition of success. We think success means achieving a specific outcome, getting that job, hitting that sales target, winning that competition. But what if we expanded our definition? What if success meant learning and growing regardless of the outcome? What if it meant staying true to our values even when it's difficult? What if it meant having the courage to try to put ourselves out there, to risk failure in pursuit of something meaningful? By broadening our definition of success, we take away some of the power that failure holds over us. We create space for growth, for unexpected opportunities, for paths we might not have considered before. This doesn't mean lowering our standards or settling for less. It means recognizing that the journey is just as important as the destination. It means valuing the process of growth and learning, not just the end result. While the journey of success is often portrayed as a solitary one, the reality is that we all need support. Having a strong support network can make all the difference when you're facing setbacks. Surround yourself with people who believe in you, who understand your goals, who will lift you up when you're struggling. These could be friends, family members, mentors, or peers who are on similar journeys. But it's not just about receiving support. Being there for others in their moments of failure can be incredibly powerful too. It reminds us that we're not alone in our struggles. It gives us perspective on our own challenges and allows us to turn our failures into something positive by using them to help others. Consider starting or joining a mastermind group, a small group of peers who meet regularly to share goals, challenges, and support. In this kind of environment, failure becomes normalized. It's seen as a natural part of the growth process rather than something to be ashamed of. The concept of intelligent failure. Not all failures are created equal. Some are more valuable than others. Intelligent failure is about failing in ways that provide maximum learning with minimum cost. To practice intelligent failure, start by identifying areas where failure is survivable and the potential for learning is high. These are your failure-friendly zones. In these areas, give yourself permission to experiment, to take risks, to potentially fail. At the same time, identify areas where failure would be catastrophic. In these areas, be more cautious. Put safeguards in place. Learn from others' mistakes rather than making your own. The key is to fail smart. Make your failures count by extracting every possible lesson from them. Document what you learn. Share your insights with others. Turn your failures into valuable data that informs your future decisions and strategies. In our fast-paced world, we often expect instant results, but real, lasting success rarely happens overnight. It's the result of consistent effort, of learning from failures, of refining our approach over time. In its first year of growth, you see nothing above the ground. The second year, still nothing. Third year, fourth year, nothing. But in the fifth year, bamboo can grow up to 90 feet in just 6 weeks. What was happening in those first 4 years? The bamboo is developing a complex root system that would support its rapid growth. Your journey might be similar. You might face failure after failure, seeing no visible progress. But if you stay committed, if you keep learning and growing, you're building the foundation for future success. Don't give up just because you don't see immediate results. Trust the process. Athletes use this technique all the time. They don't just practice physically. They also mentally rehearse their performance, including how they'll handle setbacks. You can use the same technique in your own life. Visualize not just your success, but how you'll handle potential failures. See yourself responding with resilience, learning from the experience, coming back stronger. This mental rehearsal can help you stay calm and focus when you face real-world challenges. Remember, your mind doesn't always distinguish between vivid imagination and real experience. By visualizing yourself handling failure well, you're actually training your brain to do so in reality. When we're focused on a big goal, it's easy to overlook the small steps of progress we're making. But acknowledging these small wins is crucial for maintaining motivation and building momentum. Did you learn something new from a recent setback? Celebrate that. Did you have the courage to try something outside your comfort zone, even if it didn't work out? That's worth celebrating too. By acknowledging these small victories, you're training your brain to see the value in every experience, successful or not. Over the next week, I want you to seek out one opportunity to fail. Yes, you heard that right. Find something you've been afraid to try, something where failure is a real possibility, and go for it. Maybe it's applying for that job you think you're not qualified for. Maybe it's finally starting that side business you've been dreaming about. Maybe it's having that difficult conversation you've been avoiding. Whatever it is, approach it with the mindset we've discussed today. See it as an opportunity to learn, to grow, to become more resilient. Regardless of the outcome, celebrate your courage in taking the risk. Remember, the goal isn't to fail. The goal is to become someone who isn't paralyzed by the fear of failure, someone who sees failure not as an end, but as a stepping stone to success. As you go forward from here, I want you to remember this. Your ability to embrace failure, to learn from it, to use it as fuel for your success. This is your superpower. It's what will set you apart in a world where so many people play it safe, where so many dreams go unfulfilled because of the fear of failure. You have within you everything you need to overcome any obstacle, to learn from any setback, to turn any failure into fuel for your success. The question is, are you ready to embrace failure as your teacher, your guide, your secret weapon? The journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. And sometimes that step might lead to a stumble. But that's okay. That's more than okay. It's necessary. It's part of the process. It's how we learn, how we grow, how we eventually soar. So take that step. Take the risk. Dare to fail. Because in daring to fail, you're daring to achieve greatness. You're daring to live life to its fullest, to squeeze every drop of potential out of your time on this earth. And remember, every time you fall, every time you face a setback, you're in good company. You're walking the same path as every great achiever throughout history. They all failed, they all faced doubts and setbacks, but they kept going. And so can you? The future belongs to those who are willing to fail their way to success. Are you ready to claim your place among them? Are you ready to rewrite your relationship with failure and unlock your true potential?